National Infrastructure Pipeline. The finance minister reviews national infrastructure pipeline as a part of infra spending push. The national infrastructure pipeline has been expanded from 6,300 projects at the time of its introduction a year ago to more than 7,300 projects and is making progress despite the pandemic. In the budget speech of 2019-20, the finance minister announced an outlay of 100 lakh crore for infrastructure projects over the next 5 years, 100 lakh crore for over the next 5 years. And the National Infrastructure Pipeline is a first of its kind initiative to provide the world-class infrastructure across the country and improve the quality of life for all the citizens. It will improve project preparation, attract investments, both domestic and foreign, into infrastructure, and will be crucial for attaining the target of becoming $5 trillion economy by fiscal year 2015, $5 trillion economy by year 2025, covers both economic and social infrastructure projects. See the important recommendations and observations made by the Atanu Chakraborty Task Force. The investments needs nearly 111 lakh crore over the next 5 years to build the infrastructure projects and drive the economic growth. Energy, roads, railways, and urban projects are estimated to account for the bulk. Of the projects, around 70%, the center 39%, and the state 40% are expected to have an almost equal share in implementing the projects, while the private sector has 21% share value. See, 21%, 40%, and 39%. The private sector has 21% share. Aggressive push towards asset sales, monetizing of infrastructure assets, setup of development finance institutions. See, this is a new term, development finance institutions, and strengthening the municipal bond market and see the development finance institutions. What are these development finance institutions? See, you can see the Modi government can make the rebound development finance institution a success this time. See, in this here we will discuss about the development finance institution. Narendra Modi cabinet has cleared the bill to set up a government-owned development finance institution called National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development, which will be set up with a corpus of 20,000 crore and initial grant of 5,000 crore. The initial capital will be used to raise up to 3 lakh crore over the initial capital will be used to raise up to 3 lakh crore over the next few years for the financing infrastructure investment. The intent behind setting up an FDI is to provide long-term financing for infrastructure. The infrastructure projects are complex, capital-intensive, and also long gestation periods that often pose risk to the project financiers. The scale and complexity of infrastructure projects make financing a challenge. There are difficulties in bank-led financing of infrastructure. Their liability profile is not suited for financing long-term high-risk infrastructures. Between 2003 and 2008, bank-led strategy for financing infrastructure projects was tried, but the global financial risk and the recession in the economy since 2012 made repayment of the loans difficult. Following the period saw a spurt in non-performing assets. The RBI's latest financial stability report has projected that non-performing assets of the banks could rise from 7.5% in September 2020 to 13.5% by September 2021. Banks' ability to finance infrastructure projects is impaired.